Welcome back to part 6 of our 100% walkthrough of Doom 2016, where we will complete all the mission challenges, rune trials, as well as find all secrets, collectibles, field drones, Argent Cells and elite guards, upgrading whatever we can along the way. In this level we have to find 6 secrets, 4 elite guards, 1 field drone, 1 Argent Cell, 2 rune trials, and complete 3 challenges: Dead Man, Stalking, earn 4 suit tokens, Momentum Swing, kill 10 demons using power-ups, and Sweep the Leg, perform 4 leg sweep glory kills on the Hell Razer. Okay, so the first thing I need to point out is I've swapped the rune stones for vacuum and ammo boost, and you can install 2 stones at this point. So if you want to swap them over, we can work on upgrading those.
We'll set up a portal device at the tomb. Use the light poles to mark our path.
Okay, as you're going to notice, I'm still working on my weapon mastery for the plasma rifle. It's coming along, I'm near enough completed it. Now, the first thing I want to do is work on this challenge, Sweep the Leg. We're going to identify the guy we've got to kill. We've got to kill with a leg sweep. And that's that guy right there in the middle, just above the chainsaw. So we're going to kill everything else in whatever manner you like. And the only guy left now is this Hellraiser. He's the one we need to do the leg sweep on. Now, you've got to look at his right leg when you do the sweep. Okay, not so good. So, first thing we're going to do now then is go up here and get a secret and also a little bit of armor. That's our first secret. Okay, this is where I'll complete my weapon mastery for the plasma rifle, the chain, I think it's called the chain stun. So that's updated now, that's upgraded now. Okay, just up on that ledge is a Hellraiser. So what we're going to do is we're going to just gently shoot him. Now he's in glory kill state. Look at his right leg, and there you go. That's the leg sweep. That's the first. We got another 3 to do.
Hell
So we can now pick up a yellow skull. These have actually replaced the key cards, but they do exactly the same thing. Now, just as we pass through these doors, we're going to see an elite guard. We need to collect 4 suit tokens. That's the first for our dead man stalking challenge. This here is the equivalent of Hell's datapad, so give that a press.
When the shadows first lengthened, one stood.
Now, I'm also going to be working on my weapons mastery with the explosive shot, which is a headshot using the explosive shot on imps. Only imps, only works on imps. You got to kill 20 of them. That's 2 so far. That'll be the third. So you'll see me doing quite a lot of that. If you've got the explosive shot, you need to be using it as well. Up just to upgrade that weapons mastery. Now in a minute you're going to see a Hell Razer. In fact, in this section there are, I think, 3. There's the first. Now I should really have completed a leg sweep on this guy. Unfortunately, I broke the golden rule, which is kill everything else on the map before you try completing a challenge. Because what actually happens is you'll get them in the glory kill mode and one of these other demons will end up killing them. So I completely wasted the opportunity to complete that challenge here, and you'll see at the very end I'm desperately trying to get one more of these stalkers towards the very end of the map. So try and remember that, kill everything else, then work on these Hell Razers to complete that task, that challenge. Okay, we're just going to waste these guys. Then we're going to run round to the right, where we're going to pick up a secret and a collectible. Once we've got those, we can run back and jump into that transporter. Grab that blue skull, which is effectively the blue key card. Thank you. Now, our third challenge is called Momentum Swing, and that's killed 10 demons using a power-up. There is a power-up down there which we're going to grab, and we're just going to slaughter as many demons as we can. Okay, so I managed to kill 5 there, so we're halfway there, and I think there are another 3 power-ups that we can use to kill demons, so I'm more than happy with that. Now this demon shooting at us now is called a Caco Demon. We need to carry out a glory kill on one of those towards our rip and tear achievement, which is a glory kill on every type of demon in the map. It may be a bit easier to do that later on. Now we've cleared out the area, we can make our way up the top there, where we're going to get a secret, and we'll also find a rune trial. The rune stone attached to this is savagery. I actually never used it. I never got a chance to upgrade it either. Now this, it was a real pain in the ass to do this, because I wasn't very good at jumping around. Don't worry about shooting every one of them. All you've got to do is shoot enough of them to keep you moving. That's all. You don't have to do them all. If you look at the way I'm doing this, I am leaving a few of them behind. As long as I keep moving, I'm fine. Yeah, I'm stuck there, but I can still get him. There's the last one. Now that we're through these doors, we're going to turn around to our right, and that's where we'll find our Argent Cell. Now, I grabbed this power-up thinking I'll be able to add to the challenge of killing demons, killing 10 demons with a power-up. Unfortunately, by the time I got back up here, the power-up would cease to be worthwhile, and I didn't actually get anything. Now we need to make our way along this ledge, Kill the big fella here. Super shotgun really deals with this guy quite well. As well as the chainsaw, that's really handy on him. Just follow it round into the secret, and we got ourselves a chain gun. Now these flying skulls, the best thing to do is let them get fairly close to you and just shoot them with a shotgun. You don't have to get glory kills on them for the rip and tear achievement, so don't worry about that. Now this Hell Razer, I'm gonna get a glory kill on this, a leg sweep on this dude, but it takes a minute to get it. I just seem to mess about with it too much really. Here we go, this is the one where I complete it, just straight over, watch, done. So that's 2 of 4 I've got now. Okay, now we've cleared them out, we can turn round to our right here. That's our elite guard. Pull the token, that's 2 of 4 tokens for the dead man standing challenge. Okay, so I'm going to grab this power up and I'm going to kill as many demons as I can with it for the momentum swing challenge. I think I end up killing another 3, and that leaves me, that means I've got 7 out of 10 kills for that challenge. Now, as I kill this guy with a chainsaw, my runestone upgrades start kicking in. So, I don't know what happened there. They should have been showing up earlier, but for some reason they weren't. Just before we go over this bridge, we need to turn all the way around, see where that shield is, pick that up, and that there is the auto map. It's not necessary, but download it anyway. It may come in handy if you get lost or if you want to just have a really good look around. Now we're going to make our way to our second rune trial, which is just in out now. This one here is Seek and Destroy. Again, it's a rune stone I didn't actually use a great deal, and what you've got to do is just do curb stomps, death from above, on these dudes, and it's not that hard at all. So keep out of the way of these guys, unless you can get rid of them very quickly. Otherwise, just gently lay into these dudes. They will keep appearing until you've killed all three of them or you've run out of time. It's not really a hard challenge to do. Just get close to them, look at them, jump, press the glory kill button. Continue on with the map, but before we go too far, where that shield is, we need to turn to the right and jump up here, where we're going to find a secret and a collectible. Now let's just jump across here. We're going to make our way to our elite guard, which is going to be number 3 token of 4 for our dead man stalking challenge. Directly behind him you're going to find a data log. Don't forget to pick it up and make our way up these stairs, and in the middle of this room pick up any ammo you may need. In the middle of this room here is going to be one Hell's version of a data log, so give that a press as well.
By the fires of hell, his iron will remains steadfast.
Now we need to make our way back using this lift device, and just as we run down here we're going to see a field drone and a data set, a data log. Pick up the data log, go into the field drone, purchase whatever you need. Now, that big red dude there is called the Baron from Hell. We need to get a glory kill on him for the rip and tear achievement. I'm not even going to think about it at the moment. We will get others turning up in the game. I'm just going to dispatch these guys as quick as I can. There is a power up over by the doors which I'm going to use in a minute to kill some of the bigger demons that turn up. It's quad damage, so it will make it very easy to kill them, and it's going to be the minute the summoner turns up, that's when I'm going to use it. There she is, so now it's time to use that quad damage. Okay, with this quad damage, I should now be able to complete the momentum swing challenge. Once I kill this guy, that's it done. That's it, the momentum swing damage is now complete. That's where you kill 10 demons using power-ups. Okay, now that that area is cleared, you can collect any bits and pieces you need, and we need to make our way into the back of this cave. Right there is the secret switch for our doom room. So give that a tug and then we can make our way over to it. Now what we've got to do here is just simply jump down the side. You'll see it as we go down there, and to our right it should be just in there. Now there's a secret found as well. It's worthwhile going to the back of this room because there is a power up that will give us 200 health and also 200 armor, so it's very worthwhile going to the back and getting that. Now this is where I'm going to get my glory kill on one of these Kako demons. I'm going to use the little missiles. I'll take a few hits. It's not important. I need to kill one of them first. Doesn't matter which one. I don't want them both up here at the same time. So as long as I kill one of them, that's fine. That's it. Now, I've just got to get this guy into glory state. There he is. And there's the glory kill. So that is towards our rip and tear achievement. get a glory kill on every different type of demon. So once we've done that, we can just make our way over here, where at the top of these stairs we're going to find a data log. Remember to pick it up. Just over here we've got again Hell's version of the data log. Give it a press, we're going to need it.
Quest against the blackened souls of the doomed. His prowess was shown. In his crusade, the Seraphim bestowed upon him terrible power. And with his might,
just up here where we jumped over, we're going to find our last elite guard. So pull the key from him, and that's our dead man standing challenge complete. So we've got two challenges complete so far. We've just got to get another Hellraiser leg sweep to complete all three challenges. You should be able to see the data log here. Pick that up. Okay, now in this section there's going to be an epic battle. You can just see up there, there is a power up and it's quad damage. I'm not going to touch that until I've sorted out this leg sweep on a Hellraiser. I made a bit of a mistake. I thought there was one leg sweep left to do. There's in fact two. There's a Hellraiser right there. So I'm going to very quickly get a leg sweep on him before anyone else turns up. In actual fact, he looks like he's standing there waiting for it. I'll get it right now. So that's three of four. I need another Hellraiser now to complete that leg sweep. Okay, I'll just see our Hellraiser. There he is. Now, I've got him, that's the wrong leg. I need to let him go because that's the wrong leg. I don't want to take the risk of messing it up. Not on the very, very last bit. I don't want to be restarting this map. There he is again. So let's have a go. That's the correct leg there. And yes, so actually managed to complete that challenge. Now what I'm going to do is make my way up to that quad damage and now every one of these suckers as quick as I can. Now, just up here is a Baron from Hell. I'm going to try and get a glory kill on him. I'm not going to be too worried whether or not I do. But it might be worth just trying to deal with it now. I think I actually do, if I remember right. But I do lose a real lot of health getting it. As you can see, I'm down to 26% now. Which is not... There's 9%, and there is the glory kill. So I was very lucky to complete that. Now, this is the end of the map, point of no return. You need to check to making sure you've got everything, all your secrets, you've got your challenges done. If not, in this section you could probably kill yourself and start it again. There is the opportunity to complete it. Otherwise, you may have to restart the map. If you're not that fussed, you can select it from the menu and go through it and collect what you did miss. It's entirely up to you. That was a long map, and I'm very glad it's finished.